and Punishment, Hulu. Quest, POV, PBS. Survivors, POV, PBS. Rest in Power, The Trayvon Martin Story, Paramount Network. The Price of Free, YouTube Originals.
The winner is Crime and Punishment, Hulu.
I want to say thank you to Steve and Ross for exposing the injustices that we fight against. I'm a private investigator, and I prove people innocent, and I help the poor around the states. And I want to thank all of you because of the work that you do as documentarians, exposing these injustices, helping me bring justice to people who can't afford it. In essence, bringing a voice to the voiceless. I want to thank you all. Okay?
I'm innocent.
All right, well then if you're innocent, I will get you out and free you. I'm gonna go there and see you. I need you to have all your paperwork ready. I need to write down a list of people, witnesses, so I can start my investigation. No la molesta. I'm investigator Manuel Gomez. I'm a private investigator. I'm out here looking at some cops from the 42 that have been harassing people. So if you guys have anybody, any young bloods that have any problem, day or night. So what's your first name?
Jamari.
I'm private investigator Manuel Gomez.
All right, nice to meet you.
So go ahead. So what happened to you?
I was walking out and they grabbed me like this. Then when they put their handcuffs on me, they walked me to the car and they're like, I'm like, what am I being charged for? I was asking them the whole time. When I got to see my lawyer told me I was getting charged with criminal possession of a weapon.
But there was no weapon?
There was no weapon. They just told my mom to come get me. I'm 17.
Okay. And this got dismissed.
Yeah, I have no criminal records.
He's filming me because I'm doing an investigation. What's your first name? Shaheen what?
Ricardo.
Ricardo, what's up? All right. Come on in, don't worry, I don't bite, man. Get this shit off, man. Sit down with me. What's wrong with you? Here, hold on a second. Listen. Don't worry about it. Don't be sorry. I'm not that ugly. Listen, here's the deal. For putting a major lawsuit against the department for violating state law on quotas. So what I want to know is, how many arrests do you have that were dismissed?
Every one of them I got arrested for. I never got arrested for those.
And they were all dismissed?
All of them got dismissed.
Okay, how many would you say? Five, four,
more
six?
Five.
About seven?
Yeah, probably around that.
Seven times. I want you to go in the courthouse, bring your ID, and you're going to get all the cases that says dismissed.
Right.
Okay? And you're going to bring them to me. You're going to call me up and says, Manuel, got my cases, right? And then I'm gonna file a lawsuit for all those false arrests. All right, I want you to do me a solid. I want you to go in with your mom, and I want to go in there and tell her that I'm gonna be your man. All right, you're gonna be my stepson. All right? All right, I am crazy. I'm crazy, but I'm good. You got a problem getting paid? You got a problem getting justice? All right, so you're gonna join the family? I could be here all night long meeting people like that kid, Mr. Mercado. Without a doubt. But, I mean, come on, the guy was arrested seven times. All the arrests were dismissed. What does that tell you? You're taking days out of this kid's life, fingerprinting, and you're doing this to the point where eventually you're gonna get something to stick against the wall. Because the judge is gonna say, oh my God, why does he have so many arrests? Not that, oh my God, he has so many arrests because the cops are harassing him. And that they were dismissed. No, they don't see that. This is what kills me. I mean, it's blatant. The evidence is clear as day, and they don't do anything about it. It's disgusting. It really is. they doing? What are they doing to you?
I've been here for a few years now. They always stop me.
And they stop you and do what?
Huh?
And do what?
Check me. Check out
nuts.
Put me in a car for a few and then just let me go.
They check out nuts.
Or they just let me go.
Right. And nobody's allowed to violate your rights. Did you know this? So he's over here. Do you know this? You know that nobody can come over here and frisk you and go like this and go in your pockets and start doing that? The next time one of them stop you, whoever it is, let's say if it's that one right there, you gotta let me know. I need you to take me to where it happened the night of the incident.
I'm right here, and they got me up against the gate like that. So when they got me up against like that, I'm telling them, like, yo, what y'all stop? Like, what y'all arresting me for? Like, what's all this for? You feel me?
They just pull up on me right here by the fire hydrant, hop out, jump out. Let me see your hands. Let me see your hands. I give them my hands. I'm coming up to them. I know they police. I'm coming up to them. I ain't do nothing wrong, officer. I ain't do nothing wrong. Throw your hands up. Put my hands up. They were searching me so hard. I take my jacket off. They picking up my pants. I even took my belt off so my jeans could be loose so they could really feel all everything on me.
I'm like, yo, come on, stop grabbing me. What y'all grabbing me for? Like, there's no reason for y'all to grab me. Y'all want a reason for me try to resist arrest with y'all, try to fight with y'all. I'm not gonna do that because I don't want to get locked up. So my mom's sitting there watching. That's when Nunes smacked me. Yo, boom.
I'm falling. Slam me into my leg and all that. Nigga, I'm falling. Come on, nigga.
Don't touch me because I'm pregnant. And take your light off my face. Take your light off my face.
And all this got dismissed.
All this got dismissed.
All right. Now, what I want you to do is you're going to call and make a CCRB complaint. Yeah, this is the only way we're going to put a stop to this, is when you're making complaints against them.
If you are the victim, say self.
Say self.
Self. Okay, but where to get rid of them?
Slower and louder.
Please describe the officer's actions that you would like to file a complaint about.
They frisked me and
searched me.
And took my clothes
took
off
my
naked.
Took my clothes off naked.
I was falsely arrested by the police officer, and then they released me 2 hours later after strip searching me twice in the precinct.
Your complaint has been registered. Thank you for calling the Civilian Complaints Review Board.
He's coming in, Judge.
Is Hernandez?
Yeah.
Okay. This is counter number 12, Pedro Hernandez.
Your Honor, just what I would like to put on the record, you know, we went through great pains to find this week, which is a suitable week for defense as well as prosecution to try this case. I understand that the matter was adjourned from 2 days ago administratively by the court till today. I just don't see why the prosecution were not ready for trial. The last time it was adjourned was due to the scheduling of the prosecution and the prosecuting attorney. I just don't understand what the reason for the adjournment is this time.
How old is your client?
My client's 17 years old now, Your Honor.
Okay, and what kind of offers have you received?
There was an informal offer of a non-incarceratory plea with youthful offender status that's been offered twice. My client's rejected that both times.
Is he still rejecting it? Because that'll certainly get him out in time to go to school.
He maintains it innocent, Your Honor.
He is charged with criminal possession of a weapon. He's facing up to 15 years in state prison. I just wanted to understand that a trial is a risky operation. And if he is not innocent, then the likelihood is that there will be trial evidence that will be inculpatory.
Now, and I thank the court for addressing the issue, Your Honor. And I've had extensive negotiations and discussions with him concerning plea bargain offers, and he understands the risk involved with the trial, but it's his position to reject those offers.
I've said my piece. He can proceed as he will.
712, step in.
It's still hot, or it got cooler in there?
It's hot. We got fans in here. They just blow hot air. You could give me a soft brush and a comb.
In the underwears. That's what you had told me the last time.
Yeah. Yeah, tank tops and boxes. That's it.
And I have the book that you wanted.
Which one?
All Quiet on the Western something. He say they good, but if you don't get into it at the beginning, that then you won't get into it, but that they good.
You coming over here tomorrow?
Yeah.
Well, Pedro Hernandez has been in Rikers for the past 8 months for a crime he didn't commit.
What are they saying that Pedro did?
They say Pedro pulled out a gun and shot into a group of kids. But I found several witnesses which proved that Pedro didn't shoot the kid. And the cop that arrested Pedro also helped falsify 6 other arrests against him, and he was promoted to detective. Because over the course of his career, he's made over 1,000 arrests, which exceeds the quota by 3 times. Here's the shooting victim, which I'll be meeting with later on tonight. Yeah, Sean, you there? I'm downstairs. Come downstairs. I'm downstairs. This is what I'm talking about. I gotta put an end to this. But I can't do it by myself. All right? Now's the time where I need you to lace up your boots and be hard down with me and knuckle up, because we're gonna go to a fight right now. And the fight's gonna be in court, and you're gonna tell the truth. And then after that, we're gonna go to your deposition, and you're gonna tell them to the city, and I want you to look them in the eye just like you're looking at me. Because when you looked at me like this, guess what I did? I believed you. All right, Sean. So can you just run down with me one more time on what happened the day you got shot?
September 1st, 2015. Were you in the Bronx?
Yes, I was.
Okay. What did you see?
While I was walking to my friend's house, I had seen a group of kids arguing and screaming.
So they was fighting, and from out of nowhere, I just seen this guy shot at the group.
I didn't look back. I just started taking off.
Did you realize you were shot, or?
Yeah, after a while, I started feeling the pain in my leg.
Did you see the guy who shot the gun?
Yes.
You know who he is?
Yes, I do.
You know, a female and a light-skinned cop. Ask me questions. I'm like, I don't know. I ain't seen nothing. You just keep on asking the same questions. I'm like, how I'm supposed to tell you something I don't know? Like, I ain't get to see his face, nothing. Like,
so what did he want you to do?
He want me to just say somebody shot me that I do not know from a hole in the wall.
By any chance, was Pedro Hernandez there? Did you see him shoot anybody? Did you see him involved in a fight?
No, I didn't saw him fighting, and I did not see him shoot no gun.
Was Pedro Hernandez involved in that shooting?
No.
Tell me, I'm like, I don't remember nothing. Like, he like, stop playing before I punch your head into the wall.
How come you wouldn't say Pedro shot you?
I never even heard of him until like that situation happened. Like,
that took a lot of strength for you to deal with that and stay arrested for 3 days. Mm. Wow. Any other cat would have just said,
that's him.
That's him, just to get out of here, but you didn't. I got a lot of respect for you. That took a lot of honor. God bless you. Hey, Jessica, how are you?
Excited.
Did you see the video?
Yes. We close. It just proved once again that when they're going to come out to the open, I have like a good feeling today. Didn't I tell you today?
Well, I lost them. She'll call me back. That's the first time I heard that mother happy.
So basically, we're here today filing opposition to the city's motion to dismiss for our NYPD 12 class action. All of the NYPD 12 has recordings of their supervisors pushing them to meet their quotas. Now, it's implied that, it's pretty explicit actually, in several different precincts that you need to target males especially black and Hispanic males 14 to 21.
And in the class action, we also have proof where a police captain puts the quotas numbers that he wants on the wall and then tells the guys, if you don't get these numbers, you're gonna be working in Pizza Hut. Hmm. Now you can't make that up. This is what's going on. And in this lawsuit, we show this. The department cannot correct itself, monitor itself, and punish itself. We need an independent body to do this. And this lawsuit will be the foundation to do that. I got some good news for you. I found out that there's also another video. And the video doesn't show you. It shows someone else as the shooter. And I'm in the process of getting that. I also found who the shooter was. And I'm in the process of now meeting him and getting him on video. And I'm going to have that evidence very shortly for you. It's very rare I get to say this, Pedro. But I'm 100% sure we're going to win this case. There's no way we can lose this case. I know you're innocent, and there's nothing that's gonna change that. They're gonna try to make you another offer. They're gonna try to offer you a deal to get out of here. Will you take that deal?
No, we're not.
Why?
Because I'm innocent.
I feel like I'm gonna faint.
Say what he wants to do to get out, you know?
Eat a home cooked meal. He sent to his sister to prepare it.
She's the best cook in the family.
No, no. But in that, she knows how to do the salmon with coconut shrimps. She knows how to do that good, so. But her rice is no good.
Yeah, I feel like I heard some chuckles back there.
Yeah, far from the best, but.
He sent us to prepare that for him. To say is my son is out and best moment for a while.
And you are prepared to go to trial with him?
Now we're ready for trial.
You're gonna see it through?
Yes.
And
we're gonna win. I'm trying to pass an A to Z where you can report crime and not worry about retaliation.
And we have nowhere to go to say Captain McCormick is forcing me to stop black people.
This agency would stop that. What this is saying is what we've been trying to fight for and what Frank Serpico was fighting for and cops before that.
Right.
But nobody's done it. Come on.
Hi, Alan.
Come on, this way, left.
Come on. Hey.
Where's
You all right? Are you okay?
All right, number 10 on the calendar.
This is calendar number 10, Pedro Hernandez.
I am calling 10 and we'll call 7 immediately thereafter. Second, it's been raining. You're welcome to make your application as well.
Thank you.
Travis, you're
Yes, on behalf of my client, Alex Spira.
Office of the District Attorney, Darcell D. Clark. Deputy Counsel, Julian Bond O'Connor, for the people. Good morning, Judge.
Good morning, sir. My understanding that there has been a change in circumstance at this time?
Yes, Judge. The people have conducted an investigation, an extensive investigation of this case. Notwithstanding, witness accounts in this case have proven to be inconsistent and contradictory. Therefore, at this time, the people moved to dismiss the indictment against Pedro Hernandez in indictment 2105 of 2016.
Okay, and the case is dismissed.
I want to thank Private Investigator Manuel Gomez. Thanks to my family, thanks to RFK. Thank everybody who was by my side, supporting me through the way, and helped me get this case dismissed.
Did you ever have second thoughts?
I don't
know. Nah, my thoughts was just have faith. Faith moves mountains. And just keep going.
So what about the college scholarship? That's the difference.
Yeah, my college scholarship, I'm continuing on with that. I'm going to be going on to college and starting a new life.
I'm going to go have the well-deserved cup of coffee and to sit back and enjoy the moment of bliss.
Are you going to go with Jessica and the family? Or?
I got to fight another case, and then I'll hook up with the family later on. But thank you.